What is going on, Apes the Ape Army? My name is Tyler, and welcome back to the channel for another very important AMC update video. So as you guys have already seen, AMC is down almost 6% today. And how is this even possible? It simply comes down to fraud, manipulation, and corruption that is going on with AMC stock. Because as we do know, AMC blew earnings out of the water on a revenue basis, even said that they would be profitable, or at least break even, by the end of 2021, along with multiple other things we're going to cover in this video, just so you guys are aware of how good earnings are and how bullish AMC is as a company, and just expose the fraud, corruption, and manipulation that is going on with AMC stock. Try to answer the question the best of my abilities: why AMC is falling 6% today, what I expect personally going ahead into the future, because this earnings is going to take a while to digest. Digest exactly what was said. But overall, guys, nobody could have asked for better revenue and a more bullish outlook and innovation for AMC as a business. So we have a lot to go over in this video. Also touch on the technicals, everything you guys need to know. We'll be doing a full breakdown of all of the data later on tonight after market does close. But I want to get this video out to you guys. If you are worried or panicked, there is no need to be. I will also be telling you guys what I am doing with my AMC position, offer some level of guidance or reassurance to you guys in what you guys can do with your position to ultimately combat this fraud, manipulation, and corruption. But keep in mind, I'm not a financial advisor, not a financial planner, or your dad. So ultimately, it is on you to come to your own conclusions. But with that being said, guys, let's jump right into it. Your time is valuable. Drop that like on the video, as well as comment down below and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. So first things first, like I said, we're flirting with down about 6% on the day. With AMC stock, we broke under $33, which has proven to be a resistance level yet a support level at the same time. So $33 is a critical level. We are currently sitting at $31.87. Now, with that being said, guys, we did break under this, but it wouldn't be too crazy if we pop back up above this, just because how volatile AMC stock clearly is. And we are starting to regain some of this ground. We're getting closer to down about 5.5%, but nevertheless, anything can happen here. The next level to the downside you want to watch is $30 per share. I don't think we're going back down to those levels just because earnings was so good. But with this fraud, manipulation, and corruption, anything is possible. Just have that on your guys' radar. Now, as far as what actually is going on here on a technical basis, guys, we're kind of stagnant, right? We're going up past 33, going down past 33. But the overall bullish sentiment of apes and investors in AMC should be very strong, and from what I can tell, people are very bullish. If you just type in AMC news on Google, you're seeing like zero FUD at all. You're seeing one article that this guy Jim Chanos is shorting AMC, but other than that, guys, take a look at these headlines. Let's see right here. AMC CEO says theater chain is going on offense with its $2 billion in liquidity. This one, AMC revenue beats estimates. AMC reaches deal with Warner Bros. For 45 days theatrical exclusivity in 2022. AMC says it will accept Bitcoin as payment for movie tickets by year end. Guys, every headline is bullish. It says GameStop gains as AMC CEO stokes talk of partnership. Literally everything somebody could have asked for from earnings, a lot of what we predicted would come out in this earnings call actually did happen. And I don't think a lot of market makers or people that price in expectations thought, one, AMC would be on a massive scale of revenue like they did, almost $100 million worth. That is not a shabby beat whatsoever. That is a huge beat. But also on the innovation and the guidance, we got Bitcoin news, guys. We got Apple Pay and Google Pay by the end of the year. They're also writing code right now to accept other forms of cryptocurrency and keeping their eyes open for potential areas that they can gain traction with crypto, because they acknowledge that is the future. Also, the GameStop AMC partnership, a lot of people have been very excited about this. We got the Warner Brothers exclusivity deal in 2022 for 45 days for in theatrical releases instead of at home releases. The list goes on and on, guys. So why is AMC falling? If you guys know about the stock market, like I was talking about, market makers, hedge funds, institutions, these big players in the market, they try to price in and predict what is going to happen with the stock. Now, these big guys with a lot of money, they're not placing trades like we are. They're not buying, they're not selling in the same fashion as we are. They use trading algorithms. Now, when you have lower expectations and you beat expectations, even on a revenue basis, but with all of this positive news, you should be seeing a pop in the stock. There is no other which way that you could say this unless apes are freaking out and selling out. That is simply not the case. We are the majority owners of AMC, and we're simply not seeing that. We did not see one bearish thing, in my opinion, on the earnings call. Besides, Adam Aaron did say that we are still in a COVID world and anything can happen, which was expected. Something along those lines would be said. So ultimately, I think it comes down to there really is more shares outstanding than we even know about, possibly more shares that hedge funds, institutions actually have in their broker account that are flooding the market, guys, with all of these shares, let alone other companies. I'm not even going to say the name, market makers specifically. You guys know what I'm hinting at, but nobody wants to get sued here, that are probably holding on to our buys, releasing our sells into the open market like we've been talking about, and pushing our buys into the market when the stock is cratering, when we are seeing these short attacks. So that in concept is what I think is going on here. But like I said, it takes a while for earnings to fully play out. A lot of investors take a lot of time to try to price in what all of this good news will mean for the company going ahead into the future. Like I said, this was a blowout earnings on every metric that you could even imagine it would have been. So I think it comes down to a lot of shorting, possibly naked shorting, because the share utilization is so high, sitting at 93.55%, very hard stock to borrow, and we're seeing a lot of synthetic short positions in my opinion. But to see the level of a drop we are seeing today and the amount of shares that we do own as collectively as apes, right, that we do have legal claims to, I think there's no other way to put it that we are looking at possibly 2 to 5 billion additional shares that are outstanding that are unaccounted for. Because I think it's obvious, guys, if apes are continuously buying the dip, like I see everywhere, you guys see this everywhere, we're buying the dip, these shares have to come from somewhere, guys. If one share is being sold for every two that are being bought, we are still accumulating more shares. Now, that in simple is what is going on. There is just too many shares outstanding. But what can you guys do as apes? What can we do? We can't really do anything when it comes to the fraud, manipulation, and corruption. Obviously, we would have taken care of that a long time ago. The only thing that we can do is continuously buy the dip. Because what do we know about fraud, corruption, and manipulation? It ultimately comes to an end at some point. And why was this earnings so good on a revenue basis? All the news that we did here, future innovation, revenue sources, they are looking into everything they possibly can, and they are executing very, very well. Well, that just pushed the needle up a little bit higher, guys. So if you could come to a valuation, a justifiable valuation, that AMC should be worth about $25, $30 per share, I think your downside here is very limited, because obviously in this marketplace, you're not getting any stocks for cheap. You're not getting any deals on basically any stocks. You're paying a premium for all of these stocks. So AMC will continue to trade at a premium. Let me know down below in the comment section what you guys think a fundamental valuation of AMC stock could be. And keep in mind, guys, they have $2 billion worth of liquidity. This is an all-time high for AMC stock. And at one point in the previous future, or not future, in the past, AMC was trading at about $35 when they did IPO, guys. Back here in 2015, they were trading at about $33 to $35. So I think you could say AMC could be worth about $25 to $30 per share. I think that's a justifiable valuation. After going through everything, and especially after all the new information that we have got, the innovation, I can't stress that enough. This was a great earnings. This could take some time to play out. We could see a monstrous positive day tomorrow. So nothing to be concerned about, guys, just because we are not seeing the reaction that I thought we would see coming on this earnings, which we should have seen anyways, does not mean the bullish case is over for AMC. Like I'll say this again, I think the potential downside is much less than the potential upside. That is why I continue to hold on to all of my shares and continue to buy the dip. And AMC looks pretty damn attractive at these prices, guys. So that is my thought on the situation. That is what I think is going on. In short, I think there's a lot of shorting going on, as well as a lot of our orders are being held on the books. And if you want to join a broker, link down below in the description, that does not use payment for order flow, check that out. The link is for public. Get up to $70 in your choice free stock in about 3 minutes time, with no need to link a bank account or deposit a single dollar. So definitely check that out. That'll help the cause a lot. But ultimately, I think the best thing we could do is just buy and hold at this point. So with that being said, guys, drop the like on the video as well as comment down below. Let me know what you think a justifiable fundamental valuation of AMC stock should be. My personal opinion, in between $25 and $30 per share is justifiable argument you can make for AMC's valuation. Also, consider subscribing to the channel and turning on that notification bell, guys. And if you want to be notified in real time when trades are bought or sold in stock, options, or crypto, whether it's a day trade, swing trade, or long-term investment, check out the link down below for the buy and sell alerts as well. But I will see you guys later on tonight in the next video. You guys enjoy the rest of your night. I will see you later.